myself, and I'm getting out of here. And if you know what's good for you, you will too.
Why? What's the matter?
Sean said there's gonna be a monster at the show today.
A monster? Jason, are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure. You know what? We have to tell Catherine and Martin. Come on, let's go.
Hey, everybody!
Dennis, what are you doing here? Where's Catherine?
I don't know where she is. Sean said she couldn't do the show, so he called me.
The monster got her!
Whoa, Jason, what monster?
No, Jason, hold on.
There's a monster coming to the show today, and he ate Catherine, and now he's gonna eat all of us.
Jason, there's no such thing as monsters. Tell him, Martin.
Run for your life!
I don't know, they're crazy.
They think there's a monster.
Stop! Hey, Catherine is going to eat us.
No. Catherine's fine. I just saw her.
What?
She just can't do the show today. She's fine. What's this all about? Who told you there was a monster?
Jason?
What? Didn't you say there was going to be a monster at the show today?
No, I said there was going to be an ogre.
Oh, ogre, monster, what's the difference?
Well, we're going to do Shrek for our mini musical, so Martin will be playing an ogre.
Oh, that's right.
And you'll be playing a donkey, and Gabrielle will be playing a dragon. It's just playing a part.
I'm playing a donkey.
No, aren't you too ashamed of yourselves panicking like that?
Yeah, it's a good thing the girls were around to keep our heads.
Yeah. I'm playing a donkey.
Yes, you are, Jason. Now, come on. We've got to get it together. We really need to do a great show today.
Or else the monster will eat us!
You guys are acting like freaks.
Freaks? Well, I, for one, am proud to be a freak. You know what?
Me too!
We spend our whole lives wishing we weren't so freaking strange.
They made us feel that way, but it's they who need to change.
You know what, Gabrielle? They're right. It's time to stop the hiding. It's time to stand up tall. Say, hey, world, I'm different. And here I am.
Turn in your programs. This is our sing-along song, Freak Flag. One, two, three.
Let your freak flag wave. Let your freak flag fly. Never take it down. Raise it way up high. Let your freak flag fly. Let it fly.
You know what? I think there's some people out here who don't really know this song yet. So let's learn it a little bit. Let's do a our turn, your turn, okay?
We spend our whole lives wishing.
We spend our whole lives wishing.
We weren't so freaking strange.
We weren't so freaking strange.
They made us feel that way.
They made us feel that way.
But it's they who need to change.
But it's they who need to change. It's time to stop the hiding.
It's time to stand up tall.
It's time to stand up tall.
Say, hey world, I'm different.
Say, hey world, I'm different.
And here I am, Splinter.
Gabrielle, I think that's a little too tricky.
Oh, yeah.
Let your freak fly,
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 Good singing, everybody. Now let's learn a little something about the woman who wrote the music for that song, Jeanine Tesori.
Hi, I'm Jeanine Tesori.
All right, Jeanine, so tell us a little bit about you. Are you from this area?
I am. I grew up on Long Island.
Oh, okay. Tell us about your family.
My father was a doctor and my mother was a nurse. But they believed that every child should have some kind of artistic expression.
Good
so,
for them.
Yeah, so my three sisters and I all grew up playing musical instruments. When I was only 3 years old, I could already play music on the piano, like this.
Oh! I know that song.
Well, isn't our daughter talented?
Well, all our daughters are talented.
Yes, and when they grow up, they're going to make wonderful doctors.
Now, starting when Jeanine was 5, she started taking piano lessons with a man named Richard Benda.
Hi, I'm Richard Benda. Jeanine, I'm so proud of you for learning Beethoven and Mozart. However, I want you to learn people like Carole King and the Beatles. Listen, music is music. There are so many different styles out there, and you're going to learn all of them. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to teach you about chord charts.
Wow. Okay. What's that?
So, this is a different kind of music. It has one single melody line up here, and then above it are chord symbols, like this C major, E minor, F major, G major.
But it's not telling me what to play with my left hand. And
that means you make it up yourself. You improvise, like this. Try it out. Isn't she great? She's so great.
Look at that. Our daughter is making up songs all by herself.
Yes.
And when she grows up, she can be a doctor who plays music.
Now, Jeanine's father was a doctor, and he saw patients in his own home. And sometimes, if they were really sick, he would let them stay at the house so he could take better care of them. But Jeanine's friends didn't always understand about that.
Wait, what? Jeanine, like, your house is like a hospital? That's really weird.
Mom, some of my friends are saying it's weird that we let patients stay in our house.
Do you think it's weird, Jeanine?
Well, no, but there's
well, people will always try to tell you what to think and what to do. But your father and I believe that it's important for you to make up your own mind. Do you understand?
Yes. Yes, I do. You know what, Becky? I don't think it's weird. And even if it is, I don't care.
When Jeanine went to college, at first she thought she would be a doctor or a nurse, but then she changed her mind.
Mom, Dad? I'm changing my major from pre-med to music.
Music?
Are you sure? Yes, yes, I'm sure.
Jeanine, I forbid it. You will become a doctor, and that is that.
Dear.
But you two have always taught me to think for myself.
Well, yes, but...
But that means you need to honor my decision.
It does?
I think it does.
Well, she got us. Good luck, honey.
We love you.
Oh, thanks, Mom.
After Jeanine graduated from college, she got her job as a conductor. Now, does everybody know what a conductor does?
No.
I think there are a few people who don't. Would you explain it to us?
Sure. So a conductor is a person who sort of stands in front of the band or the orchestra and directs them. They usually have this thing that looks like a stick. It's called a baton. I wish I had one. Oh, thanks for giving me a hand. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, so the conductor tells the orchestra when to start, when to stop, how fast or slow, and they direct what's called the dynamics of the music. If they're going to play very softly or very loud. So they kind of control all of those things.
All right, so does everyone understand now? Good, because our first game today is going to be a conductor game. I'm going to call four people up to make an orchestra with us. All right, the first one, if you really don't want to, you can say no thank you. But the first one is Liana. Liana?
Hey!
Yeah. Hey!
Come on down.
Are you going to come on down, Liana?
Yay!
Yay.
I always love when we pick people from the balcony. All right. Next is Adrian Grinspan.
All right.
Adrian.
Great.
You look familiar to me. Have I picked you before? Oh, okay. Well, good. Come on up. All right. Let's see who's next. Isla Giamatti.
Yeah.
All right, come on up.
Hi.
And how about Solomon Blatt?
Solomon
Blatt says no. Okay. Too bad, because I was a boy. How about Sam Willis? Sam? Do you want to come?
You want to play the drum, Sam?
Come up on stage.
No.
That's okay. No problem.
All right, let's try one more. David Smith. Where are you, David? No?
That's okay.
Everybody's feeling a little shy today. All right, let's pick one more. How about Ann Clark? Ann? Yes.
All right.
So we got four. While we're waiting for Anne, let's find out. Right, so tell us your name again.
Adrian Grinspan.
Adrian, and you're how old?
11.
And what school do you go to, Adrian?
Pleasantville Middle School.
Oh, okay. Have you ever been to Broadway Playhouse before?
Yes.
Ah, and but we've never picked you before?
No.
So congratulations. All right. So tell me your name, please.
Isla.
All right, good. I want everybody to be able to see you. And Isla, are you 11 years old too?
No.
How old are you?
6.
And what school do you go to?
PS 59.
Okay. Yay. Good. And what do you want to be when you grow up?
Maybe a conductor?
Yay. Yay. That is such a good answer. All right. Tell me your name.
Liana.
And how old are you?
7.
7. And what school do you go to?
Heights Elementary School.
Okay. And what's your favorite food to eat?
I don't know.
Well, thanks. Are you more like a candy kid, or are you more like a bagel or pasta kid or salad? What's your recommendation? I'm hungry, that's why I'm asking the question. No idea?
No idea.
All right, well, let's find out who else we got. Tell me your name.
Anne.
Hello, Anne. How old are you?
8.
Okay, and what school do you go to?
Ethical Culture.
Okay, that's a good school. Okay, so, and what do you like to eat?
I like pizza.
Pizza. All right, there we go. All right, so for this game, you're going to go over to Martin, because he's the tallest, and you're the tallest. So let's. Why don't you go to Jason? Why don't you go to Janice? And you stay with me. We're each going to give you an instrument. And, all right, tell us what we're going to do.
Okay, so for this game, I'm going to conduct all of you. And if I look right at you and I go like this, that means start playing. And if I look right at you and I go like this, that means stop playing. If I go like this, that means play very quietly. And if I bring it back up, that means we're playing really loud. Everybody got that? Audience,
got
did
it,
you
right?
get that too? Because you're going to be involved as well. So everybody ready? All right, I think we're ready to go. Yeah? Okay, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Very nice. And go! And stop. Beautiful. Sounds good? Okay. And 1, 2, 3. Start. Very, very nice. Yeah. Great job. I think you guys all get t-shirts.
So, yes, I need a t-shirt for you. You can find your way back upstairs.
Great job.
And back for you. Let's try this one for you. It's a little bit bigger, a little bit smaller. All right, let's hear it for all. So, now let's get back to the story of Jeanine Tesori. All right, so your first job after graduating from college, well, it wasn't your first job, but you became a conductor. Tell us what you liked about that job.
Well, one thing I love is when little girls come up to me and say that they've never seen a woman conductor before. Because when I was growing up, there were very few female conductors, and I remember how that felt.
Yeah, there are more now, but thanks to you.
Thanks.
Anything else?
Yeah. When I study a score, the thing I love is that it's like I'm almost getting inside the brain of the composer. I don't just read the notes. I think about why they wrote them that way. And then when I get to conduct it, it's almost like I'm making it up myself.
But after you've been conducting for a while, you sort of made the decision to change things. Tell us about that.
Well, I felt like I'd gone as far as I could go conducting other people's music. I came to the decision that it was time to write my own.
Wow.
But Jeanine, like, aren't you like one of the most successful conductors on Broadway?
I am.
But like, how do you even know you can write music?
Well, I don't. And I never will unless I try.
So she quit her job and she moved, she rented a 100-year-old lighthouse in Canada. And she moved up there and she stayed there for a whole year doing nothing but writing.
Wait. What? Jeanine, but like, don't you like get lonely up there?
Well, when the mailman comes to deliver the mail, I do kind of talk his ear off. But I'm using my time really well and I'm getting a lot of work done.
But like, what even are you writing?
I'm working on a show called Violet with a writer named Brian Crawley, and our process is really cool. He sends me scenes and lyrics, and then I send him back music. Hey, Becky, do you want to hear a song?
Yes!
Raise your foot up, that's the way. You'll be moving on today. Raise the other, put it down. Now you're heading into town. Oh boy, you got left, right, oh boy, ain't that right? Two kinds of people in this world, some say yes and some say no. Gotta say which side you're on, eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Say yes and your adventure starts, not always as expected. Say no, you stay apart, but you stay protected. My mama told me, son, forget what might have been. Give yourself a break, whatever's happening. Don't let your spirit, son, come closing in. You've got to give it room and let it in. You've got to lift up your voice and sing. Got some years ahead to go. You'll go free if you take it slow. It won't be long, and you'll be free to sing your song. There's precious little really folks like us control, but you can make your music from the simplest thing. And you're the one who's got to tend your soul. You've got to give it room and let it, let it.
Violet was a big success, and it brought Jeanine to the attention of a big Broadway producer.
Jeanie, baby.
It's Jeanine.
Uh-huh. Listen, I want to make a stage musical out of Thoroughly Modern Millie. You ever heard of it?
That old movie with Julie Andrews?
Yeah, that's the one. Listen, in that movie, Julie Andrews plays Millie. So she's this young gal who decides to be really modern, so she cuts her hair and gets a job.
Cuts her hair and gets a job? That's modern?
In the 1920s it is. Now listen, Jeanie, baby.
It's Jeanie.
Did I hear something? No. Listen, I'm going to use all the songs from the movie, but I'm also going to use old songs from the 1920s as well. And I want you to help us pick them out.
Well, that sounds really interesting.
Great.
But what would you think of me writing some new songs for the show?
Jeanie, baby. Listen, I loved Violet, but, you know, it was a little gospel-y. Let it sing. And this is 1920s Vododio style. It's completely different style.
Yeah, you know, when I was a kid, I had this music teacher, and he taught me that music is music. I wrote Southern Gospel for Violet because that's what fit that show. I can write songs that fit this show, too.
Huh. You're gonna have to convince me.
All right. So, this is a song for the top of the show when Millie first arrives in New York. Hit it!
I've studied all the pictures in magazines and books. I memorized the subway map too. It's one block north to Macy's and two to Brothers Brooks. Manhattan, I prepared for you. You certainly are different from what they had back home, where nothing's over three stories high, and no one's in a hurry or wants to roam. But I do, though they wonder why. They say home in my pocket to do with as I choose. Burn the bridge, bet the store, baby's coming home no more. Not for the life of me. Break the lock, post my bail, done my time, I'm out of jail. Not for the life of me. Gotta be more than a one-light town where the light is always red. Gotta be more than an old ghost town where the ghost ain't even dead. Clap your hands just because, don't you know that where I am and where I was? Not for the life of me. Not for the life of
The producer liked her song, so he hired her. So she and a man named Dick Scanlon wrote the songs for Thoroughly Modern Millie, and the show was a big success. It won the Tony Award for Best Musical of the Year. So now, Jeanine really had a career as a composer. Now, she continued to write shows for Broadway. She wrote a show called Caroline or Change. Has anyone ever heard of that one? It's coming back to Broadway this year. She also wrote some songs for videos. Has anyone ever seen a movie called Mulan 2? No. What about The Emperor's New Groove 2? Or how about Shrek 3? She wrote the songs for all of those. And then, in about 2014, she started working with a writer named Lisa Crone on a musical called Fun Home. Fun Home is based on the autobiography of a writer named Alison Bechdel. And the story she tells is when she and her two brothers were young kids, their father ran a funeral parlor. Does anyone know what a funeral parlor is? You must know what a funeral parlor is, right? It's a place where when somebody dies, they take the body there and get them ready for the funeral. So it's not really a place that you'd feel like playing, right? It's not a place you'd think that kids would want to live. But, you know, that's what their father did for a job, so they sometimes played around in the funeral parlor. And one time, they pretended that they were making a commercial to advertise the funeral parlor.
You guys, come on. We only have like 10 minutes before Dad gets home. All right, we gotta do this right. We worked hard. All right, all right. Six, seven, eight.
Our caskets.
Woo!
Our satin line.
Woo!
And we got so many models, guaranteed to blow your mind. You know our mourners, so satisfied. They like our formaldehyde.
Woo!
Come to the fun home. That's the Bechdel Funeral Home, baby. Come to the fun home. We got Kleenex on your choice of song. Come to the fun home. Think of Bechdel when you need to embalm. You got no reason to roam. We're the Bechdel Funeral Home. What it is, who, who, who. What it is now, baby. Who, who, who.
When Allison was a little girl, she didn't like dressing up in dresses or skirts or doing like girly things with her hair, so she sometimes felt like she didn't fit in with the other girls. But then one day, she saw a grown-up woman wearing the kind of clothes that she wanted to wear, and it really changed her life. I think it's time for another game. What do you think? All right, let's see. Siobhan, age 7, want to come on up? All right. Calla Richland. Great, 2. Yeah, you're ready to go. Thank you. All right, 2 more. How about Lulu? Lulu? There she comes. And do you want to reach in just with your eyes closed and pick one? You can pick the last one. All right, how about Han? All right, good. So come on over to the bench this time. Come sit here. All right, have a seat. So just tell me your names.
Han.
Hello, Han. And tell me your name. Say it again.
Lulu.
Hi, Lulu. Don't be scared.
Calla.
Calla and?
Siobhan.
Siobhan, okay. So we're gonna play a game now that's called...
Once upon a time, once upon a time, once upon a time, once upon a time, once upon a time.
So it's called Once Upon a Time. So what do you think the game is about? When do you hear that phrase, once upon a time? Yes.
Making up a story.
Yes, and a particular kind of story. What kind of story do you think it is?
Fiction.
Fiction, yes, and even sort of in the fairy tale department, right? Now, they're going to come through that curtain there, and they're going to pretend to be different characters from different fairy tales and stories that you're probably going to know. And if you know, as soon as you know who they are, come grab the mallet, bang the gong, and then I'll ask you who it is. So don't shout it out here, do it over there, okay? And we'll see how many you can guess right. All right, here's the first one.
Hello, I'm a little boy who never grows up, and I can fly, and I'm going to Neverland.
Anyone know who that is? A little boy.
And I wear green, and I can't find my shadow, and I have a little friend who's
so
a fairy.
Can even guess a little boy who can fly and lives in Neverland.
I'm being chased after by Captain Hook, and I have a little hat with a feather. Okay.
Peter Pan.
Yay!
That's right. All right, next one. That was a tricky one. Let's see.
Hello. All I ever wanted was to go to the ball. But when I left, I lost my glasses.
Cinderella, that's right. Good. Who's next?
I'm a little puppet boy, and when I tell a lie, my nose gets really, really...
Great.
I'm a princess, and I'm locked in a tower, and I have very long hair. Because...
That's right. Okay, good. So that we've got four right answers so far, and you two are doing all the work, but that's what you... Are you giving some answers, too? Get ready. Here we have... For this next one, let's see. Let's just leave it to these two and see if they can figure it out. Okay, who's the next one?
Hello, I'm a lady, and I live in the woods, and I have seven little friends. Sleepy, happy, dopey, grumpy, sneezy, bashful, and doc.
Do you know who
and
that is?
And my skin is as white
okay,
as
go ahead.
Snow. And I have raven black hair and...
Snow White.
That's Snow White is right. All right, so we got three more fairy tales.
I live in the ocean, but I'd give up my voice to live on...
The little bird!
Yeah, all right, you got, well, you're both getting it. All right.
Oh, I'm a little girl lost in the woods, and I come upon a cabin. Oh, this porridge is too hot. This porridge is too cold.
Goldilocks, all right.
I'm a little girl who's also walking through the woods, and my favorite color is red. I like to wear a hood.
Did you know that one, Sion? Yes. All right, so we have one more. Good, so far you've gotten all of them, eight right so far. This one's going to involve all the cast, but we're going to make it a little bit hard. They're not going to say a word. You're going to see if you can guess just by watching. On your marks. Get set. Go.
The Rockets.
Oh!
Yes!
Good.
Something
else in mind. Let's try it again. See if you. It's a famous movie. Watch this.
Juwan's going to help us out.
What is it, audience? All right, let's hear it for all of our contestants. I think we have some t-shirts for you, so come on over with me. Let's get some t-shirts. Yes. Let's hear it again for everybody. Now, the reason we played that fairy tale game is because our mini musical today is Shrek. And how many people have seen the movie Shrek? All right, so a lot of you know that Shrek is kind of like a fairy tale, right? It is a fairy tale, but it's kind of like a reverse fairy tale. Because in most fairy tales, the ogre is the villain, But in Shrek, the ogre is the hero, right? So our story begins, once upon a time, there was a little ogre named Shrek who lived... who lived on a bog by the tree with his parents. Now, it was a pretty nasty place, but that was okay with Shrek because ogres like nasty. Now, when it was his birthday one day, his parents called him in for a talk, as ogre parents have been doing for hundreds of years.
Listen, son, you're growing up so quickly. Growing up, bigger by the day.
Although we like you here, the rules are very clear.
Now you're seven,
so it's time to go away. Your mother packed a sandwich for your trip.
Your papa packed your boots in case of snow.
You're gonna make us proud, no backing up allowed.
Just keep walking,
and you'll find somewhere to go. It's a big, bright, beautiful world with happiness all around, and peaches and green, and every dream comes true.
But not for you.
It's a big, bright, beautiful world with possibilities everywhere, and just around the bend, there's a friend or two. But not for you.
People hate ogres.
They hate anything they don't understand.
That's why it's important for you to find a place to hide away from the world.
Goodbye. Good luck.
Watch out for men with pitchforks.
And so the little ogre wandered off and found himself a muddy patch of swampland, far, far away from the world that despised him. And there he stayed for many years, tucked away and all alone, which is just the way he liked it.
Who needs a big, bright, beautiful world? I got my own little patch of the world. It's not a big, bright, beautiful world, but it's mine alone. It's mine, yeah, it's mine.
Banish me, banish you, banish.
Whoa,
I don't want to be there anyway.
Whoa. Who are you?
I'm a talking donkey, can't you tell?
Yes, but what are you doing in my bog?
Well, Lord Farquaad, he banished all of us fairy tale creatures from his kingdom. He said that we have to come live in your bog with you.
With me?
Uh-huh. They'll all be here soon. Pinocchio's, the Little Red Riding Hood, and also the Gingerbread Man.
No, you cannot live with me.
Well, why not? It looks nice and roomy. Ooh, I could put my little nail polish over here and my little DVD clip.
No. I am an ogre. Doesn't that bother you?
Nope.
Really?
Really, really. Man, I like you. What's your name?
Shrek.
Treek?
Shrek.
Troke?
Shrek.
Trork?
Shrek.
Oh, Shrek. You know what I like about you, Shrek? You've got that whole, I don't care what anybody thinks about me attitude. I think that you and me are going to be best friends.
Ugh, I don't want friends. You know what? I'm going to find this Lord Farquaad, and I'm going to tell him.
Here I am.
Oh, listen, you need to get all these fairy tale creatures out of my bog.
No.
No? What do you mean, no?
I'm in and oh. But I'll tell you what I will do. I need a favor. There's this princess, see, in a dragon-guarded castle surrounded by boiling lava.
So?
So I want to marry her.
So?
So you go save her, bring her back to me, and I'll give you back your ball.
But why do you even want this princess in the first place?
I can't become a king until I marry a princess. So do we have a deal?
Ugh, deal.
Why did you agree to that? What do you know about rescuing princesses?
I've read all the stories.
I've read all the sports pages. That doesn't make me a hockey player.
Oh, come on. It's a dragon. It's a tower. How hard can it be?
You know what? I bet we're gonna find out.
You know, there's a lot of things that people do not understand about ogres.
Oh, really? Example?
Well, for instance, ogres are like onions.
They stink?
Yes. No!
They make people cry?
No! We have layers. Ogres and onions. We both have layers.
You know what? Not everybody likes onions. Parfaits! Everybody likes parfaits. Did you ever say to somebody, hey, you want to go get some parfaits? And they said, no, I don't like parfaits. Parfaits are delicious.
I don't care. Ogres are not like parfaits.
Parfaits are the most delicious thing in the entire world.
This might turn into the longest day of my life.
Well, I have the perfect remedy for that.
No. No, 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 no singing. Don't, Juwan, please don't. Oh,
too late. Sing a song, yes, a travel song, when you gotta go somewhere. Cause the fun is getting there. Oh, what the heck? I'm a convert. I love a road trip. Sing a song, hit the trail. Forget the map, forget the guide. Before you know it, you'll make strides with me. And I know what I need all along. It's a pal and a path and a song. So I'm singing and I'm traveling with you. See, it makes the time go faster.
Why me? Why me? Tell me, what was my crime?
This is nice.
As chatty as a parrot, more annoying than a mime.
Hey, look, a cat who's wearing boots. That's crazy.
Why me? Why me? A simple answer would be fine.
This is good cardio.
Won't someone please send me a sign?
Hey, look, a sign. You need a Pal Avenue.
What did I do to deserve this, honestly? This ass of mine is asinine. Why me? Why me?
Sing a song.
Why
hit
me?
The trail.
A simple answer.
Forget the map.
Would be
forget
fine.
The guide.
Whoa,
before you know it,
someone please send me a sign. What
and
did
I know
I
all
do
I need
to deserve
all
this all.
And a song, so
this
I'm singing, and I'm dancing with you.
That'll do, donkey, that'll do.
Meanwhile, in the castle, Princess Fiona was getting really tired of waiting around to be rescued.
Wow. What book should I read today? There's a princess in a tower. Oh my gosh, that's just like me. Poor Rapunzel needs a haircut, but the witch won't set her free. She passes time by singing like someone else I know. As years go by, she sits and waits. As years go by, a torturous existence. I don't remember that part. She wishes she were dead. Skip ahead, skip ahead. But in the end, Rapunzel finds a millionaire. The prince is good at climbing and braiding golden hair. So I know he'll appear, cause there are rules and there are strictures. I believe the storybooks I read by candlelight, my white knight and his steed will look just like these pictures. It won't be long now, I guarantee. Day number 8,400. the rescuers in my books.
Is that so?
You know what? It doesn't matter. I would love to be rescued. I've been waiting a really long time. Could we just start over and pretend like you haven't met me yet?
Okay. Are you Princess Fiona?
I am! Awaiting a knight so bold as to rescue me.
Great, let's go.
But wait! I have long awaited this day and would first like to know as to the name of my rescuer.
Shrek.
Shrek?
Shrek.
Well, Sir Shrek, please accept this token as a favor of my gratitude.
Thanks.
Ah, Shrek.
Well,
he can't take it anyway.
Thank you for slaying the dragon.
Oh, about that.
You did slay the dragon, didn't you?
It's on my to-do list.
Well, here she comes.
He's gonna marry you.
Well, why didn't he come rescue me?
Good question. Let's go ask him yourself. Come on.
And so, Shrek and the donkey and Princess Fiona started on their way back to Lord Farquaad's castle, but all was not well. See, Shrek and Princess Fiona really didn't get along at all.
I can't believe it. After a lifetime of misery, things are finally going my way.
Lifetime of misery. Yeah, right.
What, you don't think I had a lifetime of misery?
Oh, because you ran out of shampoo a few times in your cushy tower.
Oh, cushy tower?
Yeah.
I had nothing in that tower, fighting boredom by the hour. Princess lonely, walking circles. I had only bare essentials, army cots, a hot plate in a chamber pot, and every morning I would boil it. No choice, I had no toilet, just a view of devastation out one window, isolation in my bedroom, and very little headroom. 20 years I sat and waited, I'm very dedicated. On the wall the days were added, luckily those walls were padded. So I think I got you beat, I think I got you beat. Yeah, 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 I think I got you beat, I think I got you beat.
Well, that's a really sad story, but let me tell you, I've heard better. I'm just saying, A for effort, thanks for playing. Sad to see a princess suffer, but I had it rougher. Like that time a mob with torches burned my britches. See the scorches? You're just whiny. I had a flaming hiney. As I fled, I had to wonder if I were torn asunder. Would an ogre go to heaven? Did I mention I was seven? So, I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah, 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 yeah. I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Christmas cards.
And every day
was hell on Earth Day.
Okay, top this. I missed my prom.
My dad and mom sent me away. It was my birthday. birthday.
Well, I was sent away on Christmas Eve. Bare essentials, army cuts, a hot plate, and a chamber pot. And every morning I was toilet. No choice, I had no toilet. Just
and every day was hell.
But you could probably guess that Shrek and Princess Fiona discover they have a little more in common than they thought they did. Does anyone know the secret, Princess Fiona's secret? What's her secret? In the nighttime, she turns into an ogre, too. And you know who else get to be friends? The donkey and the dragon. And it just kind of proves that, you know, we're all individuals, we all are who we are, and that's what makes us great, and that's what we should love about each other. All right, so I hope that I will see all of you again in a couple of weeks. Are you coming back when we're going to talk about Stephen Schwartz? Stephen Schwartz wrote Wicked and Godspell and Pippin and all these great shows. But before we leave for today, let's sing again our sing-along song about Freak Flag, okay?
Ready, ready, go. Let your freak flag wave. Let your freak flag.